Go to the File menu of Affinity Designer and go to New. Make certain the Create Artboard is on, so you've got artboards created. Now, obviously you can see some artboards already there, so I've created them already. Now these artboards, maybe you've got a client that wants different designs, so you've got like zap in different places, different effects, etc., different positions of things, you can move things around. And you can see the artboards over here. You've got all the different artboards. Now what you can also do is maybe apply effects. Now, Affinity Designer does not have any effects, so you can't really do much with that. But what you can do is you can go to File and Edit in Photo. Now, Photo does not have artboards, but it does work with artboards. So straight away, there you've got artboards, and you can see over in the Layers panel, and that's in the View menu in Studio, you've got all of the artboards there. And you can expand them out, you can manipulate them, you can select them and move things around. So just go there, make certain the Move tool there is selected, and just maybe decide, you know what, I want Zap to be there, or maybe rotate it a bit. Maybe you want to add some effects. So you can go to a layer, and you can go down to New Live Filter Layer, maybe Distort, and say Twirl. So just quickly add a Twirl effect, and you can see just there, maybe like that. You just turn it around. Now it's a live effect. It's not manipulating the actual text. So that text is still there. You can still manipulate it over here. And you can also see the Twirl there. And you can remove it if you don't want it. So you can just get rid of it very quickly. And you've got different effects there. You've got a Gaussian blur there, and so on and so on. Now you've got artboards there, artboard, all the artboards, and you can still, you know what, I decide I want to change the color there. So I can change the color and maybe go for a blue or something, or purple. What I can also do is go to File, and I can go to Export. So File and Export, and then go to PDF, and make certain you go for Whole Document, and you can just save it as a whole document of obviously these artboards. So you get four artboards in your PDF. What you can also do, and I'm just gonna just make certain I can do this now, just put that there. You've got all these artboards, you can see them there. You can just simply duplicate them. Right click, and you can go to Duplicate. Now at this point, you think, oh, can't see anything. Well, you can see it's actually gone on top of that one. It's still Artboard 1. Well, what you can do, you can move it just using the Move tool, and you can move it to a different position. So there's another artboard added. And again, you can go, you know what, let's just change the color. So go for, say, a light blue this time, or maybe move that down there. And so on and so on. So you can actually manipulate artboards within Affinity Photo, even though there's no Affinity Photo artboard tool over there. Just use the Move tool just to move things around and manipulate designs. And again, use the Layers panel to actually delete things, remove things. So if you decide, you know what, just don't want that. Now, once you've done that, again, like I say, you could export it, but you can also go to File and Edit in Designer. And you can go back into Designer, because Designer's got some nice vector features that are not in Affinity Photo, and you might decide, you know what, I want a contour. So go over here to the contour tool, and then I can just quickly add a contour, maybe vary the contour in different ways, just create a nice contour design. And you think, well, I like that now, but I want to apply effects. So I'm going to File, Edit in Photo, and now you can see there. However, you can't manipulate the contour. There's no contour tool, and there's no feature, or not that I'm aware of. Maybe someone could put in the comments below if you know a way. But I just go back into Designer again. And so that's it. You can just go backwards and forwards between those with artboards and use them, apply effects, modify them in numerous ways, except not every feature is available. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.